Casey Kennedy. I'm a hydrologist with USGA. Our lab focuses on water quality, improving the water quality and drainage water supply. So today I'm going to discuss two research accomplishments from the past year. The first involved developing a cost-effective field-scale method for reducing phosphorus in surface water used for cranberry production. And this is important because elevated phosphorus levels can often lead to impaired water quality in lakes, and some cranberry bogs are sources of phosphorus to lakes. And so we conducted a study to evaluate the effectiveness of different materials for reducing phosphorus in irrigation water, the idea being that we would treat the water with these materials. So we evaluated three different compounds. There were composed of aluminum, calcium, and iron. And in the lab, we found that the most effective material was the aluminum compound. It's called alum. And so we took our results to the field. We partnered with a local cranberry grower who used his custom-built sand barge to apply 1,000 pounds of alum to two irrigation ponds. And the results were remarkable. We were able to reduce the phosphorus level in these ponds by roughly 90%. We removed 90% of the phosphorus in the water with application of alum. And so we're really excited by these results, and we think we could, with further testing, apply it to a harvest flood. That was one of the ultimate goals, because we know the harvest flood is a major source of phosphorus. So the second highlight I'm going to talk about deals with peat. Peat is an organic rich sediment. It forms the basement layer of many cranberry bogs. Cranberries are grown in sandy soils, but beneath the sand there's some peat. And the peat was formed roughly 15,000 years ago from the retreat of the last glacier. And they form in what are called kettle holes. So these are created from ice blocks from the glacier that are buried, and then the ice melts, forming depressions in the landscape. And those depressions fill with organic material, plants that decompose and form the peat. And so the structure of the peat is irregular, it looks like a bowl. But if you were to take that peat and spread it uniformly across the bog, you would have a thickness. We call that the mean peat thickness. And so what we are interested in doing is quantifying the mean peat thickness for an average cranberry bog. And so we partnered with some soil scientists at NRCS, and we developed a model that we were able to apply to half of the cranberry bogs in Massachusetts. And so what we found was that the mean peat thickness of an average cranberry bog in Massachusetts is 3 feet, and that the mean thickness of the sand layer is 1.5 feet. And why that is important is because if you look at the nitrogen concentration in the sand layer and the nitrogen concentration in the peat layer, do some calculations, you see that roughly 90% of all the nitrogen in a cranberry bog is stored in the peat. And so this kind of explains some of the results we're seeing in the variability in nitrogen in drainage water. Some bogs that have low nitrogen fertilizer programs still have very high nitrogen, and we think the peat may be a source of that. So that's all I have to report today. If you have any questions.